surprising that they've chosen Suani.
But it wasn't particularly, this is before they'd announced the team, and he wasn't talking particularly about Suani. He was saying whoever we've got, we don't think we're going to win again.
Well, yeah, I think that's it's quite nice in that it shows huge respect for this man, Peter Gaydar, at the age of 34, that, you know, other teams are saying, well, we haven't got a player to beat a man that's very nearly in the veterans, but I mean, he's still a world-class player, Peter Gaydar. You know, I do find it surprising, though, because, well, this man played against Kashyap of India and lost to him. So he hasn't shown form throughout the tournament. You know, they've got a youngster in the form of Chao Tien Chen. He also has played so far. He lost to the Thailand player, Sana. They do have another player, which I assume is here, which is Siu Yu Sin, who is the highest ranked of all the Taipei players. I can only assume he's either not here or he's injured, but they've not put him in.
As you say, the other two have shown no form, and obviously there's little confidence in them in seeing off this man, and he is kind of an indefatigable winner, isn't he?
Yeah.
Peter Gaydar, he showed the other night in the game against Korea what he is capable of doing, even with his back up against the wall final game, 19-14 down. It was an incredible victory in a charged atmosphere inside this auditorium.
Not only came back from that 19-14 deficit, saved a match point as well. But I can't help but wonder, Richard, if that match, which took an hour and 13 minutes, whether, you know, you and I know, the older you get, the longer it takes to recover after.
He was lucky that when the draw came out, not only did they avoid Korea and China, they also got an extra day's rest.
Yes.
They could have easier played the following day, in which case I think that physical that physical aspect would have taken more of a toll on Peter Gaydar.
Yeah, I think that's a very good point.
There is that match you were talking about for Suat. That was against Kashyap, who saw last time in action against Lin Dan. World number five now, Peter Gaydar. He's still motivated by the mental challenge of badminton. Not too up for the physical one, he said, but...
Yeah, look at that. Tough matches, even the two games over Reggie Vusik. And there's 39 minutes.
He was particularly busy with a win against Li Kuniel, not for just what we talked about, but he didn't have a particularly great record against Li Kuniel, which is why the Koreans picked him against him.
And players, got ready?
It's a big boost to him, and of course Tina Baum as well, she had a big boost winning her singles match as well in three games. No chance, we shall see. Sua Suani, nothing to lose, I suppose.
No, and absolutely no pressure. He can go out and enjoy it as best he can, but you know, I'm looking at his results for 2011, and three times in Super Series events, he hasn't even made it through to the main draw. He's lost in the qualifying event. So you compare that to Peter Gaydar, who already has been in two finals this year, the Super Series finals, and also the India Super Series event. That's a big gulf, isn't it?
On my right, tennis
player
represented by Sue Shani. And on my left, Denmark, represented by Peter Gaydar.
China
sniper to serve. Love all. Play.
Fantastic opening rally. Oh, what a point won by Sua Suani.
One,
he's going to run. Peter Gator around like that, we could have an upset on the cards.
I wouldn't be surprised if that's been a tactic that he's been told to try and employ, because, you know, I thought you've made the point that Peter Gator got a rest day because of the draw, the way it's worked out. You know, try and work the Dane. And that's the problem. Because Peter Gator has such an array of shots. He's so thoughtful in his tactics. He sees gaps that other players don't see and instinctively knows where to play the shuttle. And of course, with winning shots like that, he's able to go out and win rallies. He's not just sitting back waiting for the opponent to make an error.
On card number three, and an area from Holland versus Bill David from Netherlands. Umpire Francis Dhaka from India. Service judge Philip IMG from USA.
Already played one winning smash out wide beforehand. That time went for the body smash.
And that's what comes of being a wily old campaigner.
Play.
Shuttle had gone faster as he tried to play that overhead shot. That's why he made the error. Bent arm, off balance.
Tangled up. Liberated performance so far from Sua Suani. They'll be disappointed Chinese Taipei faces after those mixed doubles. This kind of performance, that's the big question now.
Yes, it is in doubt given his recent form. You know, my first two coaches of him when he reached the quarterfinal of the World Championships. It's not expected. Unseeded. He started to take the title of champion from China. In the last 16, beat Boon Sak Boksana, who was the seed in his section. You know, so physically, he's a strong specimen. This one is the inner belief.
He has been some scouts, obviously you mentioned Boksana, he's been Taufik Gideon as well in last year's Asian Badminton Championships. So he can produce it on his day. There's going to be another of those.
Quite a number of times that Peter Gaeder is pressurising from the front of the court towards Sua's body. His flat pushes, obviously feels that he's better if he's defending out wide. They're trying to cut the angle down. Oh, that's a good net shot.
Took a while for the shuttle to come down. As he did, it was disposed of. Well, we see him have a little wipe of the sweat from his eye. I can tell you that Indonesia have taken the first match against Japan. Hirianto and Aslan beating Hirata and Hashimoto in the men's doubles. Of course, the winner of this quarterfinal will meet the winner of that one.
Just missed it.
Probably so accurate.
9-8.
Wiping the sweat off.
Guess right, but still couldn't get it back.
So there you go, at the interval, Denmark, as they were in the two intervals in the leading, a bit tighter this time though.
比较勉强，耐心型的他多拍了一点。但有些的过程呢，就你往前，等他变化比较快的时候，你往前加把，那他回放的时候，你还是习惯了回放的时候。
Peter Gator will know that this is supposedly a banter as well. So
he
knows
that, you know,
in terms of the way they
looked at it.
Yes, but, you know, that does put pressure on Gator. So there's probably nobody better in dealing with pressure than Gator. You know, he's such a solid performer, but he is only human. You know, he amazes me in his motivation to carry on playing and his professionalism in the way he approaches every single match. But, you know, it's not a foregone conclusion. And I think the man from Taipei is playing very well at the moment.
When did you stop? In your badminton career, what age were you, Jill?
3 days before my 33rd birthday.
So he's outlasted you, Peter Gator, then?
Absolutely.
And it's not just longevity in itself, is it? I mean, you know, he's been winning for many, many years, but it's the standards that he keeps maintaining.
Yeah, he was first world number one in 1997. That's phenomenal. And I don't think, apart from when he was out with injury, he had knee surgery, I think back in 2000, you know, 2002. But apart from that, he's kept himself in wonderful physical condition, you know, and for him to be playing this level of badminton and men's singles is very, very physical discipline. It's just phenomenal. Stretches, gets it back, full pirouette as he does his backhand smash. Knew that his opponent was way out of position. Well, that was a physically tough rally. Jumping backwards, it seemed to be his body weight was all in the right position.
On his hand. It's nothing easy this week, Peter Gator, the game against Roger Fusev. Won the straight games. It was a fairly tight affair, and of course we've already talked about that. Match up against the Korean male singles player. So another fight on his hands here with Sua.
Was much goes when a shuttle's that short. I don't know why a player just doesn't put it away. I mean, if he'd smashed, almost certainly would have been a winner. Great spatial awareness, much more courage than I would have had.
The Danes seem very relaxed, don't they? They're enjoying being in the heat of the competition at this quarter final. And of course, they don't get to play mixed team events like this very often, do they?
No, there's European Championships and Super Cup, basically. And, that's it. So the Danes have always closer than I thought, but it was called good.
I think
the line judge was correct. Yeah, the Danes have always been very good about team competitions and pulling for each other, supporting one another.
So it's 16-14.
European champions at the moment.
Doing really well about playing the tight spinning net shots, forcing the short lift, and then he's got the opportunity to use his smash. 262. That's really impressive. Straight down the line.
I think it was something to do with the fact that Peter was walking around the back of the court and he wants him to get on with things, is the way I didn't think I could pick up off.
I think that's a bit harsh, to be honest. I think what Peter was saying in the fire was that I've got to wipe the perspiration from my brow, and if I don't go to the edge of the court, then it's going to be on the court surface, and then we're going to have to get the court mopped, and therefore delaying things even further. Oh, that's a good ride. Goodness me, surprised at that.
So this is over. 18-17.
I'll see it again. Different angle. I wasn't so sure about my initial reaction.
Stevens again.
Opening game, yeah, definitely wide.
25-year-old world number 60, pushing the man 9 years his senior. Game point as well for Gaydon out.
13, game point 19.
Good, but you know, when he was a little bit younger, his speed and agility around the courts was even better than it is now, and he's developed his game. He's had to, because he's not quite as quick as he used to be, and therefore he has to build the rallies more, and therefore it is more of a longer marathon, as you put it, rather than a sprint within his games.
Go 22-20. Who saw that one coming?
Well, after the way he played against Kashyap Bahubali of India, and the last thing, if you're thinking about the prospects of Denmark Day all the way to the final, that's a big blow to Denmark's hopes, in all honesty, because even if Gaydon were to lose this match and Denmark still win this quarterfinal encounter, you know, the fact is either psychologically he's going to lose confidence because he's lost. If he comes through in three games, physically, he's churning up the hours that he's been on court throughout the tournament.
And he's going to have to play tomorrow and the day after if they do reach the final.
Exactly. Only one high serve throughout the match. 263. Yep. Faster smashes there from the man from Taipei.
Enthralling contest we have on our hands here now. Suani has given himself the platform for a big upset. We mentioned about the has produced the odd result like this in the past. Never quite a scout like this.
I think Peter Gaydon from this end of the court, his style of play where he's going to control the net, force the lift so he can play his smashes from that far side. Of course, the players are playing with the drift, so it's very difficult to control the lift of the shuttles. Many of them go long. And therefore, it might suit the day more playing from the center of the court.
One, off.
himself, keeping the net shots going, Peter Gaeder.
Let's welcome the athletes and attendees officials up onto the court number 4.
4号场地第二场男子单打比赛，由来自乌克兰的德米特罗·加瓦德斯基对阵来自美国的苏霍华德。On
court number 4, we have Jennifer Zivadowski from the Korean.
Versus Howard from Ukraine. Yeah, it's not one that stayed in.
On turn number 3, we have Hubert Hazik from Poland versus Saba Afi from Netherlands.
Saying, can I get back onto court? And Peter Gaeder said, I wasn't the one that asked for a break, it was my opponent. So if my opponent has asked for the break in the momentum and the rhythm of play, Brian tried to rush me. I was happy to play on.
But I think that reaction from him, although justified, says a lot, because it wasn't a shrug it off, it was a bit yes. didn't he? And
yeah,
I think
he's
that
uptight.
Shows the state of his mind, yeah. Gator taking advantage of it, and every credit to him as well is Sua Suani. Proved that he can do it the other night from a huge deficit to the Gator, but asking for a lot of to do it twice in 3 days. There's a sign of a possible comeback.
Made it 4-3 to Sua, but I said that could prove a crucial rally, and I think since then Peter Gaber has been struggling. He needs to regroup,
play.
Refocus.
Yeah, he needs the interval, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Could be coming pretty soon as well. Cruise control after the mixed doubles. Against it here in the men's singles.
Yeah, when you see him play like this, you wonder why on earth he hasn't been qualifying for the Super Series events.
11,
he's lost
seven,
all qualifying rounds, he hasn't made it through to the main draw. There's no doubt in his talent.
Big crowd, big player. It helps lift your game, doesn't it? Yeah, we talked about that right at the start. He had nothing to lose at all. His manager had written off any chance of a point from the men's singles. Youngster, is he, at 25? I mean, obviously he's a lot younger than Peter Gaider, but...
Yeah, but he's not the new kid on the block.
No.
I guess right again. think that Peter Gaydon was world number one at the age of 20. So was Lindan, you know, at the age of 25, and he's just beginning to get some good results. And as yet, not consistently enough, he's more of a late developer. This is Gaber's favourite shot. Waiting until your opponent has started to come forward, thinking you're going to play a net shot, and then just at the last moment, they get deep into that forehand corner.
That proved to be the catalyst to a turnaround. Was it a flicker of hope? No more for Gaber. Determined player, Peter Gaydon. He's going to need plenty of that grit and determination here.
To hurt Peter Gaydon. I said that was a tired looking error at the end. I have to say, that last rally, it's this man who was looking tired. He really didn't react to the top shot from Gaydon. Material he is, you know, why he's won so many titles throughout his career, 36 major titles to be precise. You know, he's just phenomenal, 5 times European men's singles champion, never lost in that competition, All England champion, 4 medals from the World Championships. Missed it.
Not this time. And from 12-7 down, it's 16-12 up for Peter Gaydon. This for 10 in a row. No. Kirby be amongst those who would have been too cute to write Peter Gaylor off, but he was up against it. Still have plenty of work to do as well.
Yeah. Peter Gaylor into error.
An absorbing contest this is.
That rally, Ben Double, noticeable, sorry, that he was trying to up the pace. Well, that is such good judgment, isn't it?
Yeah, no wonder he's Ben Double. Well, in a way, Jill, from a neutral point of view, I'm pretty pleased this is going to three games. It's been great to watch, hasn't it?
Definitely.
But it's game points to Peter Gaylor, five of them. Remember, he was 12-7 down in this game. He takes it 21-15.
Second game, 1-5.
Courageous,
Denmark,
valiant,
51,
talented.
50.
Peter Gaylor turned that game on its head. So, the momentum now firmly back in Denmark's corner.
Yeah, definitely. But, you know, I know you've already said it, but I just want to emphasise it. That is phenomenal from 7-12 down. You know, I, for one, was saying things like he's not retired, but he's, you know, he's not retired well in that bad, he's going through a bad habit. For the man to come back in the manner in which he came back, it's just extraordinary. I've been watching Peter Gaylor for years and years and years, and I still get astonished by his capabilities.
And we were saying how, you know, that call and then
the court
was being wide and the reaction to the umpire, and he did for 3 points. He wasn't in the ball game at all. He was, you know, he was losing it after a couple of shots. And then suddenly the interval came, regathered his thoughts and became ever more determined.
Yeah. The mental toughness, you know, it's a rare thing in sport. I mean, we've talked about Lindan yesterday, wins 93% of his matches, games, if he's up at the mid-game interval. You know, it's all very different being a front runner. You know, these champions, these great athletes who have this capability to come back from a deficit. Now, look at the number of run falls there. Most of those, I bet, were in the second half of the game from Suat.
Final game.
Pretty even on the net play and on the attacking play.
So will this third decisive game bring us in the men's singles of this quarter final of the Sudamek Cup? It's Gaylor off.
One,
to the winning point right at the start.
This time it was the Dane who was threatening to pounce and therefore forced his opponent into error. Oh, done it again. Three times he's played that in this match, and three times he's been an outright winner. There you go. Saying well, I've got to wipe the perspiration from the face.
Yeah, he and Eddie and Fianto aren't quite seeing eye to eye at the moment, are they?
No.
Get there for tomorrow's semi-final.
The umpire, I think, has overruled it.
Yeah.
He has. Goodness me, well, maybe Peter Gaeder and Rufianto. Yeah, it was definitely wide. Oh, that'd be best pals again
now. Oh, Christmas cards now. Be exchanging those.
Weapon his own smash because Peter Gaeder is making a huge effort to keep the shuttle going down. Not all a big power attack. Took it down.
Cerny, who has put up a tremendous performance. Wasn't far away from clearing the tape there, but he's going Gator's way now.
Yes, it's not only the physical pressure that the game has put on his opponent, it's the mental aspect of it, because, you know, for a player to sort of come back from that deficit in the second game, 7-12, you know, and Sewell was playing well. But now Sewell's going to say to himself, what on earth have I got to do to beat this guy? You know, he's supposed to be an old man at the age of 34 in badminton terms. I've worked him hard, and not only is he still running quicker than me, he keeps coming back. And psychologically, the effect on Peter Gator has on his opponents is just awesome.
He's got to be feeling so good now.
Yeah.
And you're one game down, you're 12-7 down. And now you're 10 points away from victory.
11-4, play.
Hitting this rally overhead wise, no time. Peter Gator wondered if this was a fault, if he'd taken the shuttle before he crossed the net. No, I don't think so. Anything you can do, I'll do better. And again, the psychology of that, when you've just lost a rally at the net, so the very next rally, deliberately play net shots and then win the rally yourself, is okay, to say to your opponent, well, you may have had that lucky one previous rally, but I'm the master here.
Play.
He's just unable to change direction now. It sounds good to him. Shots are as accurate as that. Even if he was fresh, wouldn't he have been able to get to that? No, I don't know.
Take out of this game, even if we take a win from it. Maybe a little more confidence from his team manager, if nothing else.
Across court.
Seven. 10 points the gap. 4 points required. A Gator-like comeback.
Let's welcome the athletes and technical officials up onto the court number 4.
You did see 10 match points coming, did you?
25 minutes or so ago.
On court number 4, we have Larissa Gary from Ukraine versus Rina Wang from USA.
And there you go. It's a champion's performance for Peter Gator. I wonder the Danish team are all with me. A remarkable turnaround. And seemingly despondent position. And I get his match against Korea. Peter Gator doesn't know when he's beaten.
Yes, well, a smile and a handshake with Eddie Orofianto. Yeah, he's come through in the end, but my goodness, wasn't he made to work hard for it. But what a champion he is. Never ceases to astound me. His capabilities, his desire, and his professionalism.
Well, 21-15, 21-10, he took those final games in the end. Remember, he was 12-7 down in that second game after losing the first, 22-20. Terrific performance as well from Sua Suani. Deserves to, you know, a match is only as good as people you're up against as well. And he played his part.
Very much so. It took two players to make such a great match. And look at the number of net winners for Peter Gaeta, 7-1. That was the big difference. More overhead winners as well. And what's interesting is Peter Gaeta wasn't smashing as hard as his opponent, but he hits more winners because it's his placement and his angle of shots. And once again, Peter Gaeta winning in that game without serving high, without a quick serve, serving low all the time. But it was a magnificent performance.
Well, Denmark now leading to love in the overall fixture here, this quarter-final. Is that going to be a lead too big as far as the hopes of Chinese Taipei are concerned? Because coming next for this matchup is the men's doubles, and for Denmark, the world number one pair of Mathias Boe and Carsten Mogensen. But they're up against a pair who have had some joy against them in the past in the shape of Li Shengmu and Fang Qiamin. Should be another great game we've got ahead of us.